Now, what does that God look like? The reality of it is when he came here, he didn't look like me. So what am I going to do about that? I'm going to make him look like me. So for hundreds of years, we've been telling you, and now you have to keep in mind that we took away any other God that you might have through force, through fear, through pain, through any means necessary. So now I'm going to give you a God, but I'm going to do that in a way that is going to further me. So I'm going to give you a God that looks like me, so that when you bow down to that God, you're bound down to me. Because the reality is, the Bible tells us what Jesus looked like when he walked here. The Bible tells us what he's going to look like when he comes back. We have taken that and changed it. Do you remember when Jesus went to Egypt? He hid in Egypt. The people in Egypt, honey, they're not white people. How could he hide that? See, so that we've done that. We've given your people a God that looks like me so that you don't have any qualm about bowing down to me. See, because this is the image of God. I don't know of any sin that we've committed that's greater than that one. And we did it with the Bible in our hands when we were beating your ancestors for looking at us eye to eye. And we're quoting to them from this scripture. Even if we allowed them to have their own ministers, which there wasn't many of because we didn't allow them to read. But if we said, okay, you can have your church. This is my plantation. I'm going to do what I want with it. You can have your church. But then spies were sent. And those spies would stand outside the church. And that man would be beaten, perhaps killed, if he preached anything other than three sermons. And those three sermons were turn the other cheek, obey your master, and it's going to get better one of these days. God's going to take care of all of it. You're going to be in a happy, happy land. So put up with what you're putting up with now. And we made your people preach that to your people. And it's still being done. It's still being done. Those are the sermons that your people hear. Those sermons are what causes your people to comfort me when I do something that's wrong.
Wake up! Come on! Wake up! please wake up.